Hello and welcome back, guys. This is Ibrahim Quraishi here, and today I'm going to discuss what's new in vCenter Server. I have done a full video on all the features which I like, link in the description below. I have got the permission to share this content with you. Special thanks to VMware, Corey, and Amanda for sharing these slides with me for creating my content. For those of you who do not know me, my name is Ibrahim Quraishi. My Twitter handle is Ibrahim Quraishi, and I have been a vExpert last year and this year as well. My blog is agileops.co.uk. Be sure to subscribe to my blog and my YouTube channel. Let's get started. So this is a quick disclaimer. If you have any questions, reach out to me. So what we can do is we have our template which we have on the content library. What we can now do is we can modify it according to our need. Obviously, either it's ESX patches or installing an application on the template, and you also have version control, as you can see here. So it allows you to quickly find VM templates and versions, check out the template for editing, check in templates to save changes made, and revert to the previous versions. So like a snapshot, you can revert to a previous version. Classic and new view of summary. So this is the summary page. You can see, you know, there is a little bit change here as well, where you can see version control and everything, and you can, as I said, check in and check out. So another thing is over here, you can see you can tag it and you can basically find it quickly. The version tab basically is a little bit enhanced here. You can see that there are different versions, and it shows us what is the difference here. So the new version tab also allows quick history view of the edits. So what edits have been done and what has been changed, and versioning information only available when the VM is stored in a content library. So what that means is, if you have the template stored in your data store, it's not going to work. It has to be in the content library. So quite often we leave the templates in the data stores. This is specifically for content library. So obviously you have to have that template. You have to have this particular template which you're working on within the content library to make it to use all these new features. Okay. And then in the advanced tab, you can go in and you have an option to edit all this feature, edit auto sync frequency and performance and optimization. It's a really cool feature if you have like 4 or 5 vCenters and you want to have one consistent copy of a template. You don't want to, you know, update the template on one vCenter server and then copy it across, you know, 4 vCenter servers every time. You have it on your content library and you can set it how much you want to replicate, you know, and how many times. So you can say auto sync frequency and you can leave it. You don't need to worry about, you know, copying the updating template and copying across all the vCenters and stuff like that. So yeah, I would strongly suggest that you start using if you haven't been using this. Thank you for watching. Question of the day today is, what are the new features that you like? Comment on below and let me know, guys. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell to get all the new updates from my YouTube channel and my blog agileops.co.uk. Enjoy watching and keep sharing. Cheers. Bye.